Shyamaprasad Mukherjee, The Hindu Descent and the Partition of Bengal from 1932 to 1947 by Chanda Chatterjee. This study on Dr. Shyamaprasad Mukherjee will help the readers understand the circumstances under which he assumed the leading role in the carving out the province of West Bengal from the littoral that was soon to become the province of East Pakistan. Now, the role of Dr. Shyamaprasad Mukherjee in demanding the separation of the Hindu majority districts in the western half of Bengal from the proposed East Pakistan has not been studied so far or documented. The right historians today try to view it as a great triumph for the Hindus, while secular ones try to paint Shyamaprasad as an arch communalist. Underlying both versions of the story is an assumption that the partition of Bengal was a much sought after goal pursued by Shyamaprasad. Yet, an impassioned examination of the actual documents show that Shyamaprasad tried to work out a formula for the coexistence of the Hindus and Muslims till the very last. Only when all attempts, including that of Mahatma Gandhi in the dark days of the Noakhali riots, failed to dissuade the Muslim League from trying to push the subcontinent towards the partition, that Shyamaprasad launched his drive for the separation of the western districts of Bengal from East Pakistan. Partition was the bane of the Hindu Mahasabha. They had called a hartal on 3rd of July 1947 to register their disapproval of the idea. But once partition gained acceptance at all levels, beginning from the Congress to the Viceroy, Lord Mountbatten, Shyamaprasad saw no alternative to making the best of a bad bargain and pushed for partition. The bloodbath of 16th of August 1946 in Calcutta and the reprehensible violation of Hindu women in Noakhali the following October caused the tie. He took a leaf out of Master Tara Singh's plans in the Punjab for the regrouping of the provinces by isolating the non-Muslim population from the Muslim majority zones. The Congress Working Committee took the same line, passing a resolution on 8th of March 1947 in favor of the isolation of the non-Muslim areas in the Punjab from the predominantly Muslim ones. This strengthened Shyamaprasad's case for the partition of the Bengal. However, this was the last resort measure, falling all other options.
The epicenter was Punjab, yet many other places were affected, especially Bengal, often overlooked in the commemorations. Sindh, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Kashmir and beyond, Lahore. Here of the architecture of Mughal, Sikh and British rule, and famed for its poets, universities and bookshops, was reduced in large quartets to trouble. In Amritsar, home of the Golden Temple and also known for its carpet and silk weavers, it took more than 5 years to clear the wreckage. There are more than 600 refugee camps all over the subcontinent. 70,000 women had suffered sexual violence and the issue of the princely states, especially Kashmir, remained unresolved still. Many hopes had been cruelly dashed. The act of partition set off a spiral of events unforeseen and unintended by anyone. And the dramatic upheavals changed the terms of the whole settlement. The stories make us flinch. Bloated and distorted bodies surfacing in canals months after a riot. Young pregnant women left disembowelled by roadsides. Only the newspaper report tells us unnamed man from a village whose family had been wiped out, who, on meeting Jinnah as he trooped to the Pakistan camp in 1947, sobbed uncontrollably. Up to 15 million people left their homes to begin a new life in India or Pakistan. And by September 1947, the formal exchange of population across the Punjab borderlines had become government policy. Conscious of the fact that time is running out to record eyewitness testimony from the survivors of 1947, many people have collected memories and oral histories in the past decades. These can be and have been collected by volunteers, family members and historians. Partition history used to be all about the high politics and the relative responsibilities of Mountbatten, Jinnah, Gandhi and Nehru. These four men have always towered over the story, and ultimately their animosities and the reasons they failed to agree on a constitutional settlement make them the leading actors of an enduring and gripping drama. But today many historians are far more interested in the fate of refugees in the camp, the ways in which villagers experienced an uprooting of 1947, and or how they rebuild their lives in the aftermath.
Hi guys, I have just gone ahead and finished up today's episode with the partition of India and Pakistan. You definitely heard today what exactly happened, what were the facts during this. These episodes doesn't affect any religion views or discriminate any caste or religion views, or neither for any political views. We are here with all the real facts of Dr. Shyam Prasad Mukherjee, what exactly happened in his real life. So that's all from my end, and I would like to thank all the background members who are working behind these episodes with the editing, with the creativity, with the camera, with the photographer, and with the different scenes and other things, other research parts. So I would like to thank each and every one of you for viewing us, for watching us. We would request you to please subscribe our National Icon channel on the YouTube, on the Facebook, and on another social media platform. That's all from my end, guys, today. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.